طيب بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. طيب بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Last week, what did we say? What's the last point that we discuss? We just talk about الشرك الأكبر. We said there's a الشرك الأكبر. What is the الشرك الأكبر? To what does it mean to be الشرك? What does it mean?
Associating partners.
Okay. The opposite of توحيد. Remember, as introduction last week, I said توحيد from واحد, وشرك from أشركة. واحد, one. أشركة like شركة, company, co. So this mean more than one. So الشرك it mean to worship somebody beside Allah سبحانه وتعالى, or give anybody other than Allah share in the ibadat. طيب, the difference between kufr and shirk, we said that every kafir, every mushrik is kafir, but not every kafir is mushrik. What's the difference? We have mushrik, kafir. Mushrik is what? The polytheist, right? This is the one who believe in Allah, but when it's come to ibadah, what he does? He set a partner to Allah in his ibadah, like worshipping Isa alayhi salam. Right? Worshipping either, they said, I believe in Allah, like the people of Jahiliyyah, at the time of the Prophet, they believe in Allah, but they worship these idols to get them close to Allah. Or somebody who go to graves and make dua. Dua is ibadah or not? Supplication is an act of ibadah. So when somebody go to what you call him saint in the grave, ask him, ya sheikh or so, طيب, help me, give me health, give me money, give me whatever help. And he's a dead person. So this kind of what? Of shirk. This man, he believe in Allah, but he think that this saint man will get him closer to Allah and use him as mediator to achieve whatever he want from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right? طيب. This is called mushrik. طيب. Is he considered as a believer? The mushrik. Can you consider a believer? Disbeliever. He's kafir. Right? طيب. But there is kafir. Disbeliever, but he's not a mushrik. Either because he's atheist, he completely doesn't believe in the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of God. So he's kafir.
But he believes
other gods. Maybe some they don't believe in that. Like he believe in nature as his God.
Yeah.
Nature made itself. Or maybe worship somebody else. He doesn't believe in he said that the sun, that he can do all these things. طيب. So kafir or mushrik, both are disbelievers. But when we talk about shirk, it's to make somebody beside Allah. Like the Christian, they say Trinity, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, and they believe all these are gods, and one God, in different way they say it. So this is shirk. The people of Jahiliyyah, some Muslim nowadays who pray or supplicate the dead, or asking the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam while he's dying, he's dead, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they ask him to help him, or like the Shia who whenever they are troubled say, Ya Ali, oh Ali, oh Hussein. You hear them many times. This is shirk, because he set a partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All these are considered as shirk. So this is called what? Major shirk. Major shirk. طيب. So let's move now to our dust today. So this is called الشرك الأكبر. الشرك الأكبر. طيب. So the so-called partners does not have to be regarded as equal to Allah to be counted as shirk. نعم. يعني some people they say, no, I don't make him equal to Allah. Allah control everything. Allah, Allah, Allah. Those, they are not same like Allah. But they are get us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Na'am? Allah gave them the power of shafa'ah. You see? Those awliya. This kind of shirk. So the thing that is associated with Allah does not have to be regarded as equal to Allah in all aspects to be counted as shirk. According to the Sharia, a person is called mushrik, that means he's committing shirk, if he believes that anyone or anything is partner with Allah, even if he regards it as inferior to Allah in terms of power and knowledge. For example, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, the mushrikeen, when Allah Azza wa Jal tells us that the mushrikeen, polytheists, will say in the hereafter, what they will say, قالوا تالله إنا كنا لفي ضلال مبين إذ نسويكم برب العالمين. By Allah, we were truly in manifest error when we held you false gods as equal in worship, worship you with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the Lord. This is Surah number 26, verse 97-98. طيب. So this refers to equality in love. Only they love them. But they are not considered them as in the power of Allah. طيب. Why the shirk is serious and dangerous matter? الشرك الأكبر is most serious of sin because the one who commits shirk will not ever get out of the hell. قال عز وجل ولو أشركوا لحبط عنهم ما كانوا يعملون. So anybody, no matter what good he is doing, maybe he pray at night, he fast all days, he go and make umrah many times, many hajj, he give all his wealth, all his time doing ibadah. But at the same time, he believed that so and so he helped him beside Allah. This will nullify whatever he did. But if they had joined in worship others with Allah, all that they used to do would have been of no benefit to them. No matter what they did, no benefit. This is in Surah number 6, ayah 88. طيب. That even the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, Allah عز وجل said, addressed the Prophet عليه السلام, he said, وَلَقَدْ أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ وَإِلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ لَإِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ لَيَحْبَطَنَّ عَمَلُكَ وَلَتَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. سبحان الله. And indeed, it has been revealed to you, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, as it was to those of Allah's messengers. That means we reveal to you and all other messengers that what? If you join others in worship with Allah, then truly all your deeds will be in vain. So this was addressing to whom? The prophets and the messengers. Which means teaching to their followers will certainly be among the loser. This Quran, verse number 39, verse 65, Surah number 39. So, the one who is guilty of shirk, the one who commits shirk, he will not be forgiven. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَنْ يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah certainly forgive all sins. No matter what sin man commit, Allah will forgive it. But if he die in the state of shirk, he will not be forgiven. Never. That means he will obey where? In the hell fire. This is it. طيب. If the mushrik he repent during lifetime, is it accepted? Yes, it is. Why? Because this was a time of tawbah. You remember when we talk about repentance, about tawbah? We said there is certain time. If the person, return and repent to Allah, Allah will accept from him. A person before he die, 1 day or 2 days, and he say shahada and he repented from shirk, and then he died. We say alhamdulillah that he repented. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was trying to the last moment breath with his uncle Abu Talib. He said, just say la ilaha illallah, that means give up this shirk so I can ask Allah to forgive you. So, you see, so the person, if he repented before his death, then it will be accepted even if, but the one, when we said that will not be forgiven, that the one who die in the state of shirk, then it will not be benefit him. It will not be benefit him. Na'am? Right. قال تعالى about the Christian, لقد كفر الذين قالوا إن الله هو المسيح ابن مريم وقال المسيح يا بني إسرائيل اعبدوا الله ربي وربكم إنه من يشرك بالله فقد حرم الله عليه الجنة ومأواه النار وما للظالمين من أنصار. This is the message that all prophets told to their followers, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here is giving the example of whom? Of Isa alayhi salam. Surah Al-Ma'idah, يعني verse 70 to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said the meaning of this ayah, surely they have disbelieved, those who said this disbelieve, who say Allah is the Messiah, Jesus son of Mary, but the Messiah Isa alayhi salam, al-Masih, said, O children of Israel, worship Allah, my Lord and your Lord, verily, look at this, verily whosoever sets up partners in worship with Allah, then Allah has forbidden paradise to him. Paradise will be forbidden for him. He will not be, you know, entitled to enter paradise. And the fire will be his abode. And for al-zalimeen, the wrongdoers, there are no helpers. Nobody will help them. That means it's telling them that even me, at that day, I cannot give you any help. So from this, we know that and understand the dangers of help. طيب. This consider as the greatest crime and the worst sin. Why? يعني subhanAllah, because just imagine, Allah Azza wa Jal is created you. He is the one who is giving you. He is the one who is taking care of you. And then you go and give thanks to somebody else. SubhanAllah. Just imagine, even if in our life here, just you have somebody who is helping you, and instead of telling him thank you, I appreciate what you did, you go to somebody else and give him thanks. And when you see this, you think that he did nothing without the help of the other one. Where is your mind? This is the logic, see. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who created, and Allah Azza wa Jal is the one who gave. And Allah Azza wa Jal honor you that he didn't command you to enslave yourself to anybody else. This is an honor for man, that he never ever even bowed down for anybody except the one who created him. So you leave this honor and you humiliate yourself for creation like yourself. Or maybe they are more, you know, they are weak than you, like, you know, something like stones. What can stone do for man? SubhanAllah, idols.
Related to this shaykh,
yes.
One Hindu asked, being God, he should not feel, even if he is not worshipped, he should not feel like human being, that he was, he felt ego or something like that. The point that you discussed now, that you should, the question of that disbeliever was, even if Allah is not worshipped, he should not feel, as you said, that greatness, like that, he should not feel.
Yes, matter.
That word, the God, is a similitude like the human being.
No, you see, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, here Allah Azza wa Jal send you a messenger, right? He revealed books, right? He told you, worship me alone. Don't set any partner beside me. So he is commanding you here. He's telling you, we are not speaking about does this harm Allah or benefit him. You got my point? Because the Hadith Qudsi would say that لو أن أولكم وآخركم جنكم وإنسكم. This Hadith Qudsi. If all of you, from the first one to the last one, the jinn and mankind, they all get together to harm Allah Azza wa Jal, they cannot harm Allah. They all together get together to benefit Allah in one thing, they will never benefit Allah of anything. If all man and jinn, they all were disbeliever, this will not decrease from the kingdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If all men and all the creation disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this will not decrease in the kingdom of Allah Azza wa Jal. You get my point? So Allah Azza wa Jal doesn't, you know, hurt him or affect him if all people disbelieve. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is able to remove all this creation and make another creation. See? But here we said this is the rights of Allah on us. And this mentioned in the hadith when, if you remember that Anas, is it Anas? Mu'adh ibn Jabal, radiallahu anhu. Mu'adh ibn Jabal. One time he was riding behind the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the donkey, remember? The ass. And he said, Ya Mu'adh, ata'lamu ma haqqu Allah ala al-abid wa ma haqqu al-abid ala Allah. Do you know what the right of Allah on his creation, on slaves? And what the right of his slaves on him? He said, Allah wa Rasuluhu a'lam. Qala haqqu Allah ala al-abid, the right of Allah on his slaves, that they should worship him alone. I never ever associate anybody beside him in his worship. And the right of his slaves, that he will not punish the one who doesn't associate partners with him. This is why the one who die in the state of Tawheed, even if he commits sins, like zina, for example, zina, or stealing, or any other sins, he may be, there's different scenario. Either Allah Azza wa Jal forgive him, Allah is forgiver, and give the one who that this person make wrong to him, he give him something to satisfy him, to please him. Allah forgiver. This is one out of his mercy. Or maybe he could be what? Punished for some times in the hell. So Allah Azza wa Jal gives honor to his prophets, to the angels, to some of the righteous people. They give them the honor to get this man out of the hell. Honor for them. This is what call it shafa'at. Intercession for him. They intercede for him. This is honor Allah gave it to whom he wished. But even this shafa'ah, it does not happen by the choice of the person, but what was given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, when you ask anybody, you wish that the Prophet intercede for you. You don't ask the Prophet, oh Allah, oh Prophet of Allah, shafa'li, or be my shafi' in the day of judgment. You don't ask him. Why? Because the Prophet ﷺ would not do anything without what? The permission of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Therefore, you ask Allah that He allow or permit His Messenger to intercede for in your behalf. You got the point? So this is very important that we always direct the ibadah, the request, the supplication, the invocation to Allah alone. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا يَشْفَعُونَ إِلَّا لِمَنْ ارْتَضَى. They will not, all these shufa'a, malaika, prophets, la, they will not intercept except for whom he pleased. Not by their own. Na'am? طيب, هذا حديث, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said, I asked the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which sin is the greatest with Allah? Now, look the answer. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, that you should claim that Allah has a rival when he has created you. How come he created you? He is the one alone who created you. And then you make rival with him. Subhanallah, where is your mind? Right, so this is the greatest sin according to this hadith. And this hadith mentioned in Al-Bukhari wa Muslim. In fact, the Quran itself declare it very clear that shirk is the greatest sin. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, Surah Luqman, as you know, إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَظُلْمٌ عَظِيمٌ. Verily, joining others in worship with Allah is great wrong deed. نعم, ظلم. قال تعالى, وَمَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ افْتَرَى إِثْمًا عَظِيمًا. Surah number 4, verse number 48. I'm repeating this number because some sisters, they requested that whenever we mention any verse, we refer the number so they can go back and check it if they want. Right. So in this surah, surah number 4, verse number 48, and whoever sets a partner with Allah in worship, he has indeed invented a tremendous sin. Right. There is one ayah, the Sheikh, he didn't mention this in the book, but Allah Azza wa Jalla answered those who they said, we only worship them to get us closer to Allah. وَالَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِهِ أَوْلِيَا. Those who take partners, or they call them wali, and they claim they get us closer to Allah. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, so even these people, when you ask him, brother, why are you doing this? They say, Sheikh, I know that he is a man, but he's the righteous, mashallah, waliyullah. This is waliyullah. And then I ask him to get him closer to Allah. Ya Sheikh, you didn't read the Quran. The Quran said that there are some people who claim that when they invoke or supplicate or worship somebody else, they said to get us closer to Allah. And you condemn this act. So how come you do it? Where is your mind? This is why, my dear brother, the problem of some people, even some Muslims, they depend on their religion, on what they inherited, just imitating their community, their forefathers, people around them. They don't go back and read the Quran. You say, well, I don't read Arabic. Subhanallah. Even first of all, this, subhanallah, first of all, you should learn Arabic. You have no excuse. How come you learn English? Because you can get work and business in this world and get income, subhanallah, and get better education. And you don't learn Arabic to get paradise, Jannah. And you'll be able to read the word of Allah Azza wa Jalla who created you and understand it. But even if you don't understand Arabic language, you don't know it. Alhamdulillah, now there is many translations for the meaning. Just go and check what the ulama said. Book of tafsir is already translated. Authentic tafsir like Ibn Kathir and others, Qurtubi, Tabari. Most of these books of tafsir their meaning were translated. Therefore, nobody has an excuse that he said, well, I just, you know, resemble people because I don't know how to benefit from the Quran. طيب, the second type of shirk called shirkun asar. We have akbar wa asar. Akbar, that means biggest. Asar, that means the little one or the smallest. نعم, which is minor. Minor shirk is action such as showing off or doing things for the sake of created beings and not performing acts of worship purely for the sake of Allah. This means a person may do things sometimes for the sake of his ego or for some worthy purpose. Example, a person, he pray. That's nice, he pray for the sake of Allah. This is why he went to the masjid, right? But when he's there, he saw his boss, the manager of his company, there and look at him. So now he has changed a little bit. He's thinking now, my boss is looking at me. Well, I made it, you know, perform salah is take good care of my salah, so I'll not make mistake. So now he is, even he doesn't know, he's associating somebody here in his ibadah. And there's joke about this, just to make the class a little bit not always serious. There's one man who was praying, as they said, you know, and mashallah, he was, so when he saw some people are coming, so he was perfect in his prayer. So there's people that said, mashallah, look at his prayer. Allah, mashallah, nice prayer, mashallah, he's perfect. And he's hearing them. So after he finished, and he looked at them, and you know, I'm also fasting. So that even the head of ibadah, he wants to share with us. you see, that's me. I'm doing this salah in this way, and I'm fasting. So what would happen if I'm not fasting? If I was eating, that's me, I would have more, maybe. Subhanallah. So this is just a joke, but to show you that some people, this is why, my dear brothers, we need to take good care of our ibadah. Naam? When giving charity. This is why Salat al-Nafila, it's better to do it where? At home. So Salat al-Nafila fil bayt, it's better than do it in the masjid. Only the obligatory prayer. So therefore, for example, if you are at your home and you hear the adhan, before, and the adhan is finished, maybe it's better to do 2 rak'ah. And then you go to the masjid and you pray. You finish your salah. You are not going anywhere. You are going back home. So it's better to do the nafila after the salah. You do it at home. You see, why salat al-layl is better than any other salah? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned, خير الصيام, صيام يوم المحرم, خير الصلاة صلاة الليل. The best of all prayers. Why? Because at the night the dark people are sleeping and you are alone praying. There is no way for show off. Nobody is watching. So the sincerity is more pure. Naam? So this is very important. Even sometimes with words, we may make shirk. Like saying, if somebody asks you to do something, say, okay, whatever Allah wants and you want. Now you make him equal to Allah even with words. But if you want to say, whatever Allah wants, mashallah, and then what you ask for or what you ask, what you wish. Then, like some people, when they make swearing, they say, وحيات النبي. Like our brothers, the Egyptians, this is common among them. They say, Wal Nabi. That means, well, by the Prophet. That's correct. You see, if anyone who wants to swear, he should swear with the name of Allah. Man kana halifan fali'i billah. Aw liyasmut. It's hadith. The one who wants to swear, he should swear by the name of Allah or not. Or he should not swear. Some people now, they say, by the head of my son, by the head of my daughter, by the head of so and so. Hear it or not?
Yeah.
Naam? Rabb al-Kaaba is okay. Because Rabb al-Kaaba, not al-Kaaba. Rabb al-Kaaba, the Lord of the Kaaba. Who is he? Allah. If you say Rabb al-Nabi, no problem.
In India, generally we say swear and mummy. Swear and mother.
By my mother.
Yeah, this is very common.
No, this is also not right. This is not right. You see, by the mother, by the head, by the manager, by the king, by the president, by all this. I met one time I was talking with one American, I said, by the head of Reagan. Swear by the head of Reagan. At the time of Reagan. That's not correct, you see. So the Muslim should always, if he wants to swear, he swear by the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this consider as shirk aswar. Bukhari and Muslim narrated from Abu Musa, a man came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, said, a man who fights in order to get the booty. You know, he want to fight just because when they finish, he wins something out of this fighting. man who fights in order to become famous, he said, well, he is, you know, a well-known, courageous person who fights in order to gain high status. Which of them is fighting for the sake of Allah? What was the answer of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? He said, the one who fights in order that the word of Allah may become supreme is the one who is fighting for the sake of Allah. من قاتل لتكون كلمة الله العليا is the one who fights for the sake of Allah. So the one to stay away from shirk, he should what? Do this for طيب, for the sake of Allah. Imam Muslim related, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam narrated that his Lord, Allah Azza wa Jalla, this hadith, Qudsi, I am so self-sufficient that I am in no need of having any associate. Thus he who does an action for someone else's sake as well as mine will have that action renounced by me to him whom he associated with me. Taraktuhu wa shirku. He did this, he gave charity, for example, gave money. He said this is sadaqah for Allah, but at the same time to show the people that he is generous and he is doing this for show off for these people. So Allah will not accept it. Said, okay, you did it for these people, let them reward you. Let them get the reward. And you remember the hadith which is in Hadith Qudsi about the first three people who will be thrown in the hell. Can you imagine? The first people who will be thrown in the hell, it's not those disbelievers. Three people who claim that they did something for the sake of Allah. One of them is fighter who fight for the cause of Allah. One is reciter of the Quran. And one is generous person, rich man. The first one, he fight for, you know, in jihad. And then he died. And then the day he will stand and said, what you did? He said, I fought for your sake, O Allah. Allah Azza wa Jalla knows what's in his heart. He said, no, you are a liar. You are lying. You fought to be, so people, they say he is courageous man. He has courage. Right? And then the people said this. So that means you got your reward. This is what you are looking for. And it was said. So he will be thrown in the hell. The other one, he said, what you did? He said, oh Allah, I learned the Quran. I teach the people the Quran. And he said, Allah Azza wa Jalla, for your sake. Allah Azza wa Jalla will tell him what? You are lying. You did this to the people. They said, Qari. Al-Qari. Sheikh Al-Qari. So people, they will praise you as Qari. And they said this. So you get what you were looking for. It's already gone. So you'll be thrown in the hell. The third one, he will ask him, what you have? He said, you give me money. I was rich, so I spent in all ways for your sake, O Allah. Allah knows what was his intention, so he will tell him, you are lying. You spend your money, so people, they would say, you are generous man. And it was said, right or not? Said. People, they said about him during his lifetime, he's a generous man. Sheikh, mashallah, he's generous. So you got what you were looking for. So he will throw in the head. So these are the types of shirk. So this is why, my dear brothers, always we need, you know, to take good care of our intention.
Sometimes it may happen that somebody generously giving the money, some people know, and they will backside telling, he's a good man, he's giving.
No problem. It was mentioned by some Sahaba. They said, oh Prophet of Allah, sometimes the person he do good and he prays by others. Yeah. The Prophet, this is the urgent glad tidings for the believer. This is like good news for him. But here, his intention. It was not to, they do this, okay? You try to go and hide your sadaqah and give it. Somebody notice. It's not your, okay, problem. He's the one who...
Maybe the one who receives, he told that.
Maybe the one who received it said, oh, so and so he gave me. Yeah. Some people say, oh, Allah, he's a generous man. So the important thing is that when we do the act,
intention,
we make sure that our intention for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, what I fear the most for you is al-shirk al-asghar. They said, oh, Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is al-shirk al-asghar, minor shirk? He said, showing off, al-riya. They call it al-riya, showing off. طيب. Allah Azza wa Jal will say to them, as mentioned here, and this mention in Mishkat al-Masabih, Hadith number 4334, and Allah will say to them on the day on which He requited His slaves for their action, that's meaning the day of judgment, go to those for whom He used to show off in the world and see whether you can find any word or anything good with them. You used to go to these people to please them, okay, let them give you your reward today. Naam? Right. I think we took more time. Okay, I think we finished. The last verse we emphasize here, this surah, as you know, surah Al-Kahf, last verse in the Surah Al-Kahf, فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا. So whoever hopes for the meeting with his Lord, let him work righteousness and associate none as a partner in the worship of his Lord. And we stop here, inshallah. And so, what page is this? So, inshallah, next week, brief history of the creed of Aqeed. Inshallah, we'll talk about it in very short next week. Jazakumullah khair. طيب, any questions? Any question or comment? Yes.
Doing Nafla Salah at home. The Sunnah Salah at home.
Yes.
Or going to the mosque early.
Yes.
Sometimes you know you get the feeling more when you are in the mosque than when you are.
Yeah, for sure. You know if you have the time to go
early
with this intention, that's good. But after you finish the Salah, then you can pray the Zimna after the Salah. You can do it at home. Because also waiting for the Salah, this is great ajr. The important thing is the Muslim try his best to keep his work, always look at his intention, to make sure that for the sake of Allah. Also, my dear brothers, we should be aware, the Muslim should not go and always in doubt about himself. Because this is the shaitan, maybe play a game with him and say, you are not praying for Allah, you do it for this and that. Don't listen. You know yourself better than anybody else. Since your intention for Allah, just put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't listen to the whispering of the shaitan. Jazakum Allah khair. See you inshallah next week. Barakallahu alaykum. Assalamu alaykum.
We're going on vacation, Sheikh. I'll follow you on Facebook inshallah.
MashaAllah. Jazakallah. Yeah, you can follow through Facebook so you will not miss any. But you are lucky. We almost finished the book.
Inshallah.
And also, I advise my brothers, sharing knowledge is shared by itself. And anyone who learns something, he should share it with others. In this way, you don't know how many people they will be guided through you. So those brothers who cannot attend, you can send them the link, you can send them, give them advice. When you sit with them, tell them what you learned. Sharing these videos and other groups. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us all. جزاكم الله خير. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us sincerity, whatever we do. جزاكم الله خير.